Hi guys, so welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing a haircare update. This video is probably one of the most highly requested videos on my channel right now because I made a lot of videos in the past about no poo, about natural hair care, about my process with growing my hair out, and then I kind of just stopped making those videos. And I'm gonna answer all your questions that you have on my hair, what products I'm using, how I dry it naturally, what things I'm doing, if I'm doing no poo anymore, and yeah, I'm gonna go into detail about all of those things. Today's video is a sponsored video with Function of Beauty, and that is the product that I'm currently using and loving. So thanks to Function of Beauty for sponsoring this video, and let's get into it. So the first question I'm gonna answer is if I'm doing no poo anymore. If you have no idea what no poo is, it basically just means no shampoo. I journaled my whole journey with no poo back in the day when I first was making YouTube videos. I had really short hair, and I wanted to start taking care of my hair better, make it healthier, make it thicker, longer, and stop using lots of products and lots of heat on my hair. So I stopped straightening my hair, I switched over to using only natural products and homemade products, and I also even tried out water only. If you wanna watch that whole series, then I have a whole playlist on it, and it was kind of fun to document the whole thing, and lots of you guys followed along and also tried it with me. I also made an ebook after that whole experience and during that experience all about natural hair care and natural beauty, and there's lots of information in that ebook all about how to do no poo, so you can check that out in the description if you're interested. But I recently have switched from, oh, actually not even recently, I have not been no poo for a while. I've been kind of doing low poo. So within the whole kind of no poo, low poo community, there's all these different weird terms. No poo kind of is basically when you use only natural products, homemade products, single ingredients like flowers or water only or apple cider vinegar, whereas low poo is switching to natural products like natural shampoos that are free from SLS, free from parabens, free from sulfates, and lots of like nasty ingredients that end up making your hair not as healthy. And I switched from no poo to low poo when I moved to Brighton because the water in Brighton was really hard, and doing no poo with hard water I found impossible with my hair type. I don't know if it may work for some other people, but a lot of you guys may have experienced this frustration, and I had a lot of you guys messaging me when I was doing no poo saying, I don't know what to do, my water is hard and my hair feels sticky and waxy and disgusting. And that's exactly what I experienced when I moved to Brighton, and it was very frustrating for me because I'd been doing no poo for a while, my hair had been loving it, and then suddenly my hair got really waxy, really kind of stodgy and gross, and I had to make a change. So I started doing low poo, trying lots of different natural shampoos and natural products. I used a shampoo bar, but honestly nothing really worked as well as I wanted it to, and it was getting a bit annoying. My hair was being kind of frizzy and kind of difficult. So I then came across Function of Beauty. They reached out to me and they said, hey, do you want to try my products? And I said, yes, please, because I want to see a natural shampoo and conditioner that's actually going to work for my hair. And this stuff is amazing. I really genuinely love it. And that is why I've waited for so long to make a video about my hair care, because I wanted to properly understand what low poo products worked for me if you're interested in using more natural hair care to help your hair grow and to keep it healthy. That's what I wanted. I didn't want to go back to just using whatever shampoos and conditioners and stuff. I wanted to keep it natural and nice, and that's why this fits. And also this is really, really cool because of the fact that you can fill out a quiz online, basically. So you can cater this to your hair. That's the whole point of it, is that it is a specialized product for your hair, unique to your hair type. So I had to select different things that I was after. So I'm gonna let you know what I chose. So when you go on their website, you will see that you can go on there, you can then pick the different things. It's kind of like a little quiz. So the first thing I was doing was choosing my hair type. So my hair type is wavy, medium, and normal. So I selected that first, and then the next thing is your hair goals. So my hair goals were to have anti-frizz, curl definition, shine, soothe my scalp, and hydrate. As you can see, I have wavy hair. It's quite long right now. It's pretty long, in fact. I really need a haircut. And I need anti-frizz because my hair tends to get frizzy, and just to sort of define the curls. So I think it does the job. It is exactly what I was after. I also chose the colours, which is also kind of fun. So I chose a pink shampoo and a blue conditioner. And you can also choose the scent. I chose peach, and it smells like something from my childhood that I can't put my finger on. But it really reminds me of something from my childhood that I used to use, which is lovely in the shower. And you can also select what it says on there. So I chose Function of Madeleine, which is just kind of nice. And this has lasted me a really long time, and I don't need a lot of it. I find shampoos nowadays, whenever I use them, last me about 6 months, and this one is, yeah, holding up well. So what's great about these products is that it's unique to your hair, so you're not just picking up anything off the shelf and then it not working. I did have that experience when switching from doing the natural products to using products again. I was finding a lot of the ones I was trialing, I was spending a lot of money on them, and then they just wouldn't work for my hair type, which was frustrating. So for me, it's very important when I was switching from no poo to low poo and finding natural shampoos was that it would keep my hair healthy, because I wasn't going to undo all the hard work I'd done by not straightening my hair and using natural products. And that's why I really like this, because it's not got any of the sulfates, the parabens, or any of the chemicals you find in a lot of shampoo and conditioners that stop your hair from growing, make it frizzy, make it feel heavy, make it greasy, and all of those things. And you can pick the unique formula. Also, of course, it is 100% vegan and cruelty-free. That is a top priority as well. So it kind of ticks all the boxes for me. Function of Beauty have kindly offered you guys a 20% off discount code if you click the link in the description. So you can take the quiz, find your unique formula for your hair type specifically, and get a nice product in the post. It is amazing. I honestly have noticed a really big difference since using it on my hair. And yeah, I highly recommend it. Let me know in the comments down below what hair goals you have, and also what colour you're gonna opt for if you do end up getting yourself one of these. And it's currently available in the US, Canada, Great Britain, Australia, and New Zealand. So now I'm gonna kind of go through my hair routine, because that's the main bulk of this, and I've already talked enough about no poo, low poo, and my new product that I've been loving. But basically, I wash my hair once a week. Probably it's a little bit more than that. It's like once every 5 to 6 days, depending on what I'm doing. Sometimes you wash your hair a bit sooner, sometimes you leave it a bit longer if you're feeling lazy. But yeah, I typically wash my hair every 5 to 6 days, because that is, I find, the best way for me. I trained my hair to not be needing washing every other day when I was doing no poo, and that's honestly one of the best things you can do for your hair. If you are experiencing your hair not growing, or not feeling healthy, or not feeling good, don't worry about doing no poo or low poo or anything. Just wash your hair less, stretch it out, and try and train your hair not to get greasy, because that is what a lot of products do. They kind of train your hair to get greasy faster, so then you need to use more product, and then the cycle continues. Luckily, this doesn't make my hair greasy. I definitely tried a few products when I was switching to low poo again and using products again that made my hair greasy really fast. So thankfully this doesn't do that. So before the shower, I always use a wooden brush to brush my hair. I normally do this the night before. It's kind of like a little miracle worker. It will basically condition your hair and actually kind of absorb a lot of the grease. Sometimes I'll do that the night before, and then the following day I find that actually I don't need to wash my hair anymore, because it has kind of distributed all the grease. It's really, really good for your scalp. It's really good for hair growth. It's honestly one of the best things you can do, and I did it all throughout doing no poo, and I've continued to do that. I don't really do it during the week anymore, just because I like to keep the waves in my hair, but I do it the night before I intend on showering and washing my hair. So I do that the night before, and then I jump in the shower, wet my hair, do the shampoo. I do wash my hair twice with the shampoo, but I try not to overuse on the product. I find the second time I wash it, it just really lathers up a lot better and gets in there, because I do have a lot of hair. But maybe if you have shorter hair, you don't need to wash it twice. And then I use conditioner. Now, adding conditioner was a change, because I wasn't using conditioner for a long time, but I was finding that as my hair was getting longer, it was getting frizzier, and it definitely needed conditioner on the ends, and it has made a big difference actually using conditioner again to the frizziness of my hair and the moisturization, is that a word, of my hair. And I think maybe I just had conditioners in the past that I didn't agree with. I stopped using conditioner a couple years ago, you may remember me mentioning it, because it wasn't making my hair any better, it wasn't really improving the condition of my hair, but I find this conditioner makes my waves kind of have, you can see each individual one, and it just stays looking nice. I don't know, I find it just hydrates my hair. So I use a conditioner, I use quite a lot of it, and I use it to brush out my hair with my fingers. I try and not use any hair brushes when my hair's wet or kind of after the shower. So I use my fingers in the shower to comb through the conditioner and get out any tangles, and then I rinse that out. And then when I'm out the shower, instead of using a towel to instead of using a towel to dry my hair, I use a t-shirt. This really helps with defrizzing your hair. Towels often have lots of piles on them and lots of fluff, which kind of irritates your hair and makes it frizzier, whereas a t-shirt is much smoother, much softer. Some people go as far as, I think, using like specific things like silk pillows to dry their hair or whatever, but a t-shirt works just fine. And I kind of put my hair in the t-shirt, wrap it up, and let it kind of absorb a lot of the water and the moisture. I'll then do whatever I need to do with putting deodorant on, moisturizing, that type of thing. And then when it's kind of absorbed some of the water, I will take it out, and then I will use some argan oil. This is the only product I use on my hair post-wash. Lots of people say to me, what products do you use in your hair, etc. I will only use argan oil. It's pretty much the only thing I've used for the last, I don't even remember, like 4 or 5 years. I just don't use any other products. I actually got this in Marrakesh recently. So yeah, it's like proper argan oil and it is amazing, honestly. I only use a couple pumps of it. I will just put it through my hair and then scrunch it, and I give it a proper good scrunch and comb through, and then I just kind of leave my hair to do its thing. I don't use any heat on my hair at all anymore. I think that's helped it grow, it's helped it keep it healthy, and it's also helped to bring back the life to my waves and the natural shape of my hair. When I was straightening my hair all the time, the natural shape of my hair kind of disappeared. So that's been amazing to kind of have my hair be back to being wavy and looking healthy. Yeah, honestly, argan oil, get yourself some. Not only is it good for your hair, it's good for like so many things. It's a really great multi-purpose product. You can use it for massaging, you can use it for moisturizing on your legs, on, you know, it's a great thing to have. So yeah, those are the only three things I'm using on my hair right now. It's kind of like the dream combo. I love it. I think that now I'm in Cornwall, I might try doing no poo again, but also while supplementing with this, because this is great to obviously keep your hair clean and stuff, but I want to try making my own natural products again and seeing how it works with the soft water down here. But for now, I'm just really happy with the convenience of using shampoo and conditioner and knowing that it works and makes my hair look nice. So yeah, the only other thing I can think to mention is the fact that I don't actually cut my hair often. That's kind of bad. I should probably cut my hair more often, and I'm definitely due for a haircut because there are some split ends happening, but I tend to only cut my hair like every 4 to 6 months. Just out of laziness. I also stick to hairstyles that aren't going to damage my hair too much. I tend to just put my hair in plaits or a bun on the top of my head, and I usually use a scrunchie. The scrunchie I use is from Hara the Label. They actually sent me this, but it's like a nice little soft hair tie, and then I use those, what are those, plasticky kind of spirally ones as well, because again they're a bit more gentle on your hair than elastics are. But I try and, yeah, stick to things that are gentle on my hair so it's not going to break my hair too much. Another thing that I do when it comes to hairstyles is I will put my hair in a plait at night and then wake up in the morning and it gives it a nice wave if I'm kind of like on day 4 or 5 of not washing my hair. Sometimes the kind of waves have disappeared and it doesn't look so fresh, and I will do that and it will work really, really well. And then I'll kind of put a little bit of water through the ends so that the ends don't look weird. So I think that I've covered everything. Let me know in the comments if you have any other questions that I haven't covered. I will also leave a link to my ebook in the description, as I mentioned, if you are interested in doing no poo. And also I will leave a link to the Function of Beauty products if you want to get yourself some, because genuinely I highly, highly recommend them, and they have been a great switch for me. And if you are after that and you are struggling with the whole no poo thing but you want to use something natural, check out Function of Beauty. Go also check out my Facebook group, because I have a Facebook group called Minimal Beauty for any of your questions about hair care, beauty. I might do a video like this on my skincare routine and that kind of thing. And I hope you enjoyed the video. This is my hair. and I will see you in my next video. Bye.